Hello, everybody, and and this is ITV's Halloween special.
This is Cooper Dachi with ITV, and today I'm going around asking people what they're going to be for Halloween. What are you going to be for Halloween?
I'm going to be a DC sorcerer magician named Zatanna. I have two Halloween costumes. I'm going to be Weird Barbie from the Barbie movie, and then Columbia from the Rocky Horror Picture Show.
A fairy.
I haven't decided what I'm going to be for Halloween yet because I'm too immersed in the interlocking life.
I'm going to be Lady Bird from the movie, and she's going to be my boyfriend. She's going to be Kyle from Lady Bird.
I'm going to be Wart from Over the Garden Wall.
A shark.
A what?
A shark.
I'm going to be first a vampire and a black swan.
Morticia Adams.
Ken.
Barbie. I'm just Ken.
I'm going to like... box of cereal, and then I'm gonna have like a little like plastic knife from stone, and I'm gonna be a serial killer.
Interlaken has some amazing things that happen in late October and early November. Most notably, Faculty Lane trick-or-treating. You're gonna get a lot of candy, but make sure to wear something warm. It can get pretty cold. This year, it will be on October 29th. At Faculty Lane is across the main road and to the left. Hope to see you there. We also today have the decoration set up. Each department and each rotunda has decorated, and we get to vote on what's best. So make sure to make your way around campus and see all the decorations. Interlaken also has a vast community of artists from all different backgrounds. So we like to look ahead to November when we have some other holidays coming up.
I'm Mari Farrant for Interlaken TV, and this is Rebecca Marquez.
Yes.
I'd just like to first off ask you, what is Día de Muertos? What is it about?
So Día de los Muertos is a celebration. I like to think of it as a celebration. So this event is primarily in Mexico. It's not really a whole lot seen in other Latin American countries. And the whole thing is about your ancestors and people who have passed revisiting you for about 1 to 2 days. And so they come at night. And the way that they come is that you put out food that you know that they liked, and you also put up their photo on an altar. There's the most elaborate altars are about 7 like layers. Here at Interlaken, we're not going to do 7 layers. We don't really have that kind of vision in mind. We are going to put up photos of our own family members, and also we did this last year. We put up celebrities or people that we really like connected with. So we had Selena on there. And so basically what we do is that we put up their picture. We put up foods that they like or things like little mementos that we know that were part of this person. And so at night they come and visit us, and it's just a nice way to remember and not forget about their passing. So Día de los Muertos, we're going to hold that in the gazebo. What we're gonna have is we're gonna have an altar. The number of layers is still yet to be determined, depending on the amount of people that wish to put their relatives on the altar. And we're gonna decorate it with papel picado. We're also gonna have some food out there. Again, like it's outdoors, we have to figure that situation out. We're gonna put flameless candles. I really like the idea because it looks really pretty, especially if you go at night. Mm-hmm. And we're going to be doing that on the 4th and 5th of November. We're going to be setting up the ofrenda the previous week. So if that makes sense, we're going to set it up this week, this Saturday and Sunday, but we're going to be actually holding the event with TC Latino coming in and having tacos on the 4th and the 5th.
Is this going to be in the evening?
Yes. Because I believe the 4th is a Friday and the 5th is a Saturday. So the 4th, I'm not exactly sure which day TC Latino is going to come in. I'm hoping for probably 5th because more people will be able to show up. But, you know, it has to be determined.
Is this a just LSU activity? activity or is it open to?
It's open to everybody. A lot of the LSU events are open to everybody. In fact, LSU is open to everybody on campus, primarily because we don't have as many students as we did last year to fulfill the positions that we have, but also because I think it's very important for the community to be educated on, you know, what LSU is, who we are, what our values are, and just kind of get to know us as people, you know? Yeah. So I think it's good to have everything pretty much open.
So when about does this take place?
So these things happen. Yeah, so the actual event happens on November 1st and 2nd. November 1st is for a select group of people who have died. So like it's been like, I might have this wrong, but I think it's your elders and basically everybody who isn't a child. November 1st is dedicated to those people. November 2nd is dedicated to children who have passed. So that's when that's actually celebrated. However, we're gonna celebrate it on the 4th or 5th because those are days that align with Interlochen scheduling, essentially, because November 1st and 2nd is in the middle of the week. People have classes, we have community meetings, we have stuff that we have to attend to.
Right. Now, you were talking about the upcoming community meeting, yes, which they're going to celebrate LSU. So what are you going to be doing?
So the community meeting that's coming up this Wednesday, the LSU is going to be hosting that community. So technically, we're going to kind of just like take over the stage and we're going to present and show ourselves to the community in a way that we think celebrates Hispanic Heritage Month. And I think it's a nice connection to Dia de los Muertos.
That was Rebecca Marquez talking about the upcoming events here at Interlochen for Dia de los Muertos. Thank you very much.
Well, today has been a very fun day. But October can be really stressful for a lot of students, so make sure to take some time for yourself and take a breather. It's okay. Well, I hope to see you all next month. Happy Halloween.